श्रीमते रामानुजाय नमः। Actually, today's topic is an intellectual strain and load to most of the students as well as the masters. Because to mastery a single faculty or a dimensional study of a widespread faculty, it requires arduous tasks and Herculean exercises. And to have a mastery, which is nothing but study of convergence of four different faculties of subtlety. Subtlety in promulgative wisdom is known as information technology, and subtlety in the foundations of life factors is biotechnology, and subtlety of the so-called particles or matters of existence and actions that are included in nanotechnology, and the subtle force which makes the person to analyze, to design, to direct and to dedicate, to devise the systems as well as the tools for understanding this is cognitive technology. So it is just like asking a student to write all the examinations of botany, zoology, chemistry and physics on the same date, or giving all the questions in the same question paper. So to understand the convergence, even though just we can give a formal basic introduction by which we can realize how a convergence is possible on selective or application oriented fields, still it is a very great brainstorming and mind-boggling discussion. Still, lot of people, they know about cognition. The word to cognize, to recognize, these words are very commonly used in the routine vocabulary. And what is the role of cognition, number one? What is cognition science, number two? If there is cognition science, what is cognition technology or cognotechnology or cognitive technology, number three? Number four, what is that type of cognitive technology in which independent handling of wisdom of a human being that has been mentioned in our scriptures, number four? Number five, what is the conventional NBIC convergence which they are trying to plan or which they are trying to implement just as they are in the threshold level itself? They are looking for a lot of opportunities to implant it for the total development of the society as well as tackling the issues of or global challenges of the modern society. So I have to just give a clear information that what you think of NBIC convergence is entirely different from, it is not different from what I think of NBIC convergence. It is not a difference between thoughts of two levels of extremities or two dimensional approaches. What we think traditionally is orthodoxical and it may be different from modern or heterodoxic view of the convergence. But what I want to say is, what really NBIC convergence is entirely different from what the real convergence is. So now we have to point out these flaws and insufficiencies in this convergence issue, even the planning itself. You see, if there is a primary question, it has been asked by somebody, the impact of a subtle tool known as mind, that is written psychology, the impact of a tangible tool known as brain is read in neurophysiology, neuropsychiatry, neurochemistry, neurolinguistics, neuroprosthetics, neurobiology, innumerable sciences are there with various affiliations to brain studies. If mind is read in psychology and brain is read in neurology, then what is the use of cognitive science, which is embedded inside which? So the process of thought, there is a school of thinking that the thought emanates from mind. Mind is a subtle tool and brain is the servant of mind. It is the traditional belief of our Indian systems of knowledge, in which they call that mind as the subtle tool, which is an internal organ, which also activates the brain. But according to modern neurology or even the latest computational neurosciences, they see that each and every response of what we call mind and its impact is depicted only by a neural process. So this type of brain studies by neurology as well as mind studies by psychology how they can be related to cognitive sciences. Cognitive sciences is a wider area which covers all tools. So interdisciplinary studies between neurology and psychology is neuropsychology, but they are entirely different from each other. They are interdisciplinary. Likewise, cognitive science that deals with different dimensional approaches of the concepts of cognition. Cognition is of different types, and it will take a differentiation to explain cognition itself. Cognition starts from awareness. You know that the basic identity of living organisms is consciousness. That is, it is aware of its awareness, and the degree of awareness that differs. For example, microorganisms, they may not be having more awareness. Their awareness of reproduction, their self-structuring, sheltering, self-security mechanisms, those things are very limited. In the more higher species we go, the response of their awareness, it is more and it is sophisticated. In human beings, being the ultramost special standard of organisms, we see different types of cognitions. And even amidst human beings, we are having a lot of people, starting from idiots to intellectuals, lazy people to dynamic personalities. This cognition, it reflects due to ecological, biological and various other different factors. Cognition can be defined as the force of a living organism which makes the person to start from awareness till the end of realization or perfection. The wider area that is covered inside, everything is nothing but a manifestation of the so-called cognition. So cognition is a common nomenclature of innumerable standards and grades of behaviors, internal behaviors. These behaviors are known as, for example, memory is a behavior. Perception is a behavior. I see a thing. That is known as perception, number one. I understand the thing. That is known as comprehension. I understand that I understand. That is awareness. I retain the same thing in my mind. That is memory. I design something. I erase something. I jump from one concept to another concept. I determine at a particular status. I am vivified by an experience. I totally am petrified or inert to an experience. These type of internal responses of different kinds and grades are collectively known as cognition. And science, cognitive science, reads about these things. That is, starting from perception, comprehension, memory, direction, design, execution, individual functioning or collective functioning, eco response of individual and individual's response of the eco. All of these studies, there are hundreds of such faculties. So cognition is a study of various grades, stages and manifestations of internal behavior of an organism which is non-biological. Which is non-biological. It may be based on biological thing, but it is not made up of biological thing. That we will discuss now. So this science is known as cognitive science, and technology is of two types. There are two types of cognition technology. The first type is a application of your cognition in practical implementation or translation of anything you want to achieve is known as cognitive technology. That is Siddhi. We used to call in Sanskrit as Siddhi. I am thinking something, I have a mind to design, I have a mind to pattern, I have a mind to understand static systems, dynamic systems, complex systems, simple systems, intricate system, intrinsic systems. I have a mind, but whatever I formulate in my conceptual